Hello everyone, welcome to Sources Classes. So in this video again we will be continuing our discussion with respect to questions pertaining to the quantitative aptitude section of the paper. So if you talk about the QA section this year, the paper seemed to be a little bit on the difficult side. That is the kind of question we have seen being asked this year round. They were somewhat complicated as compared to the ones we have seen being asked in the previous year's paper, to such an extent that this year they required an in-depth understanding of the subject matter just to attempt and solve them, and also this contributed towards making the question more calculation intensive and time consuming as well, increasing the overall complexity of the section and the paper as well. So what we'll be doing in this particular video is we'll be taking a look at the question from the paper itself, and then subsequently we'll try and solve the same so that we have a general idea about the approach involved with the question. Okay. With all that said and done, let us focus on the question at hand. If the highest power of 5 and n factorial is 24, find how many such numbers are possible. Okay, now it's given that highest power of 5. Power of 5 in n factorial is 24. Okay, so highest power of 5 in n factorial is 24. Now let me give you an example. Suppose how this 20 we arrive, so how many such numbers are possible. Okay, now try and understand something. Suppose we have a highest power of 5. So how this, suppose we have n, say, so initially if we divide n by 5, this should yield me say 20, okay, or something 20 to something on that range. And then subsequently, if I divide again n by 5 squared, it should yield me say something like 4. Okay, so do we have any such number in this regards? So suppose I take 100 factorial here. Okay, suppose n factorial equal to 100 factorial, that is n by 5, if I do, I'll have say 20, and then if I again do, n by 5, let me write this properly, will be equal to say 100 by 5, or we have 20. Okay, again if I do 100 by 25, then we have 4. So we so what we have, 20 plus 4, 24. So n's value, n factorial value can be 100 factorial. Okay, this can be the value. Now how many such number will be, how many such number will have 24 factorial? Now see, had this number, this 4, been 5 plus 1, had this been 5, that is one more extra 5, then our number of 5s would have been 25, that is not 24. We have to select a number in which this particular value of 4 is increased by 1. So let me take the value of 105. Okay, say n equal to 105. And now if I am looking to find the number of 5 in this case, this will again be say 21. Okay, and then subsequently if I go 21 by 5 or 25, 105 by 25, it comes out to be 4. Okay, so instead of 100 by 25, comes out to be 5, sorry, 4. Okay, now see one thing, this 21 plus 4 turns out to be 25. Although we were unable to increase 1 in this spot, we are able to increase 1 over here in 105. So that is, any number which is less than 105 and more than 100, that is from 100 to 104 factorials, will have the highest power of 5 as 24. Okay, so therefore our answer in this regards will be numbers that is from 100 to 104 factorial. Okay, that is 5 numbers. Okay, so this is one way of doing this, by simply checking all the powers in the same. This method might seem a little complicated at first, but try to understand the explanation that I've given. So let me explain the same as well. We need 24, so we have to figure out a value in which, because we are dealing with 5, right? So a number initially has to be concerned with this 20, okay, because we cannot have remainder more than 5 in this regards. So closest one should be 100, so that way if we take 100, we see we get 24 number of 5s, okay, and then subsequently we check for 5 more, that is we increase one more 5 in this regards. Then we check for 105 and we see the number of 5s in case of 105 comes out to be 25. So that way we can conclude the numbers are 5 in number, that is 100 to 104. Okay, so kindly go through the explanation and subsequently try and solve this question. I don't think you should face much of an issue as far as the process involved. Okay, now if you're looking for a detailed solution of the entire paper or you have any doubt with respect to your computer exam preparation or any subject or topic wise explanation that you might need, feel free to connect with us. For that you can go through the description screen and feel free to connect with us in all these regards. Okay, so having said that, if you like the video, make sure you like, share and subscribe to the channel. So with that said, I'll be signing out. Thank you so much.